Hi everyone, welcome to this week's studio vlog for the end of November. I've been trying to get out and about more, so I thought I would head to the local cafe and work on a pattern design while I waited for my coffee. I haven't quite got used to working at cafes again, so I got a takeaway coffee and took it home with me. The walk was nice though, and I might do it again sometime. On the weekend, I headed to the craft store to pick up some leather. I would like to try making my own accessories for my pens, so I'm going to try my hand at stitching leather. After that, I headed to the art supply store, where I finally bought myself a proper drawing board and a small lino block because I misplaced the last one I bought. Good morning everyone, it is Monday the 21st of November and I thought this morning I would start off with some journaling in my sketchbook. So I've been trying to do some journaling about my day, like art journaling and making little sketches and things, but to be honest it hasn't really been going all that well. I've got a couple of sketchbooks in here, one that I made myself with some watercolour paper and one of the standard traveller's notebook sketchbooks in here, and I went ahead last night and sketched out a rough outline of what I would like to watercolour in the traveller's notebook insert. So I'm gonna go ahead and try that today, complete the layout and see how the watercolour goes on the paper. It should be interesting to see because I've never really tried that before. Anyway, time to start some art journaling and yeah, I will do a little time lapse. Here's the finished pencil sketch, really quick. The aim of this is just to sort of get everything down on the paper and then I can come back to it and finish it later. I also realised that my time lapse cut out really quickly, so there was only 10 seconds of that, I'm sorry. But yeah, I'm hoping to come back and add some really nice sort of maybe text with a brush pen, add the writing and all the details and stuff, and then colour this with some watercolour and maybe some colour pencils. But now I have other things to do, so I can't finish this I think today. I have to go and do another different sketch, so I'm going to go and work on that and then we'll come back to this another time. Just before 5 o'clock on the 24th of November, and I just had to go and pick up this parcel which has arrived all the way from Britain, which is pretty exciting. I follow a lovely lady dabbling in journals on YouTube, and I was quite surprised to find that I'd won a parcel, a journaling parcel with a beautiful journal in it. And yeah, it's actually the first time I've ever won anything on YouTube, so I was extra surprised. And this is it right here, it's come all the way, so I'm going to open it up and we're going to look at the beautiful, beautiful journal inside that I won. And yeah, I'm just so excited and thank you so much for sending it. This really honestly is like a really nice way to end the week. Okay, I'm just going to carefully move this away so I don't show any information. I am going to carefully cut the parcel open. Oh, it's all wrapped and everything! Oh, thank you so much! Okay, let's open this first. I do remember what is in here, but not all that well. Like I remember the main journal bit and a few other things, but I've deliberately not really looked. so that I can have a nice surprise. But I will put the name of the lovely handmade journaling person who made this, the Etsy shop, up on the screen, and I will put it in the description below as well, so that you can go and check these out. And I will also put Ali's channel, Dabbling in Journals, in the description with a link, so you can go and check out her channel as well. Okay, let me just very carefully undo this here. I'm not terribly good at opening parcels quickly and efficiently, so I'm probably going to fumble quite a bit. I love this little clip on the tag here, that is so cute. Oh, and the stamps on the parcel as well, with the stamps. There was a tracking thing, but no stamps. I was thinking, should I save the stamps? Stamps from Britain. But let's open this before I distract myself any further. Now, Ali from Dabbling in Journals makes beautiful journal spreads, and they're all like vintage style, with lots of distressed ink and beautiful bits and pieces, and she does art and watercolours as well. So if you like that sort of thing, you would definitely like her channel. I'm tearing the paper. Oh, cute! So in the... I remember I like these little post-it notes that say, I think, by the way, but you can tick whether it's a big deal or not a big deal. I thought that was pretty nifty. And then we've got some lovely goodies that I think came with the little folio journal originally, and some washi tape on a cute little holder here, which is quite nice actually, because I don't have like a washi tape holder, and it's got some beautiful patterned tape on here, so it's got this lovely is it like a rose gold pattern? And then we've got some memo tape as well. This looks pretty cool. Maybe these are little memo tabs you can fold over pages and stuff with numbers. I think that's really cool. And then these lovely handmade paper clips with the little beads on them. So everything will totally get used in my journal. And I love paper clips and clips and things, especially for like my art journals, for holding stuff back when I'm doing watercolors. So that will be very useful. I'm sorry, I'm holding that, not even in shot. There we go. And then there are these really cute little tags. Yes, they are the gift tags, because you can punch them out and they've got a hole in them. I love the colours. Those will be very, very pretty. And the delicate little illustrations on these as well are lovely. And then we've got some stickers. Hello there! Oh, I like these. These are positive. Wonderful. Stay true. Oh, yes. Oh, beautiful smile. Awesome. Okay, now I will move this out of the way, and I think, is this a, oh, this is beautiful! Let me just, I'll take the note out and have a look at it, make sure there's no like personal stuff on it, which there shouldn't be, but it says, I hope you enjoy your beautiful journal, my best wishes, Ali. On the beautiful vintage paper as well. Gosh, that's so lovely, thank you so much! And then we've got some of these lovely stickers. Which I know are super fun for putting in journal spreads. Just put those there. And then some paper samples and things. Oh, thank you so much. This is so lovely. So we've got a classic-y tab. I'm sorry, tag? I'm probably holding it in the wrong place because I'm kind of leaning around the camera, but there we go. go, there's a tag and some cute little other paper samples. Oh, and these ones that you press out, I've seen these being used in Ellie's vlogs, and they look really, really cool and really useful for embellishments. So for myself, I've only really just started getting into things like journaling this year. I've always had a planner and a journal and things like that, and I love traveler's notebooks and things, but for the fun decorative side of things, I've really only started having fun with that this year. So this is all, in a way, some of this is kind of new to me. Like, I've seen it in people's vlogs, I've watched a lot of videos, but I've never got into it all that much myself until recently. Just because I haven't really made the time to do it, because I do a lot of my art and stuff. And I think this looks like a beautiful handmade folder that's been made by Ellie as well, with the distressed ink. That is so nice. So yeah, I don't do anything like this, but I enjoy watching people do it. I love all of the creativity and things. Now this is the main event. Oh gosh, I hope my camera is still recording. It says low battery, so I'd better open this a little bit more quickly. Let me grab the scissors here. In fact, instead of rushing, let me see if I can stop recording and set this up in a way that I can not have to worry about the batteries. One moment. Okay, hopefully this is better. I won't have to worry about the batteries now. Slightly different camera angle. So I'm just going to very carefully open this. I know you're probably all screaming at the screen to go faster, but I'm also trying not to rip the paper too much. I say ripping the paper. There we go. So this is the beautiful handmade leather folio. Which was the main part of this giveaway, and I think this was especially made with this pocket in front and everything. Ellie had it especially made for the giveaway, so I'm just gonna open it up so we can have a look. It's got an elastic band on it so you can close it, and inside is a Stylogy notebook, I think. I've never actually used one of these. I'm quite excited to try it. This one has a grid in it and it lays flat really nice as well. Some stationery brands like this, like, you can get them here in New Zealand, but they're a little bit difficult sometimes to find. I think I know of one online store that carries them, but I only found them quite recently. But yeah, this is the case. Oh, I'm so sorry, there are people across the street that have decided now is a good time to throw scaffolding onto the ground. But yeah, this is the folio, and I will put the name of the beautiful colour of the leather up on the screen, because I can't remember quite at the moment what it was. I think it was something like toffee or fudge, something delicious sounding. And this is a beautiful hand... Oh gosh, I'm so sorry about the noise. This is a beautiful handmade leather folio. Thank you so much. It was such a lovely surprise to win the giveaway. And I'm really looking forward to using this and taking it out and about with me to make notes and do journaling. I think this is a perfect size, just to pop into my bag, maybe with some extra little bits and pieces in here and a pen. And I'll be good to go, maybe with like my watercolor kit and stuff. So thank you very much. I super appreciate it, and yes, absolutely made my week. Thank you so much. On Friday afternoon, I was able to take some time to go sketching outdoors, so I walked to the beach and enjoyed the sunshine. Please excuse this lovely shot of my feet walking, but the beach was super crowded with people sunbathing everywhere, and I tried not to point my camera directly at people in public places. The ocean looked that day. I wished I could take off my shoes and splash about in the water, but I went and found a picnic table instead and settled down to do some sketching. I chose a table close to a tree with a good view of the water and started a rough pencil sketch. After I finished the sketch, I got out my fountain pen and inked it. This was the first time I had used my platinum preppy pen with the carbon ink cartridge for drawing outdoors, and I was very happy with the results. I'd also brought my watercolour set with me, but by this time I had been at the beach for just over an hour and the sun was so hot on my back I thought I would head home. I like that using the fountain pen makes the sketch look finished, and thanks to the carbon ink, I can always go back later on and add watercolour without worrying about the ink bleeding. I hope you enjoyed this studio vlog. Thank you very much for watching. Thank you also very much to my patrons. Your support makes videos like these possible. I will be back again soon with another art video. See you next time!